ഹായ് ഫ്രണ്ട്സ്, ഹൗ ആർ യു ആൾ ഡൂയിങ്? ഗ്രേറ്റ്. വാട്ട് അബൌട്ട് ദ അസൈൻമെന്റ് ഐ ഗേവ് യു ഇൻ ദ ലാസ്റ്റ് ക്ലാസ്? ഡോണ്ട് യു റിമെമ്പർ ദ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ? സീ ദ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ. The young man told his story to the doctor. Prepare the likely conversation between the young man and the doctor. Have you done it? Here is an answer sent by one of my students.
How foolish you are. Life is very precious. What made you think of such an attempt?
You don't know how unlucky I am. I lost my parents when I was young.
Who helped you then?
My uncle helped me find a position in a lawyer's office.
That was a good job. Then why did you try to commit suicide?
Sir, you should listen to my story. I was all alone. I didn't have friends. I fell victim to the loose society of the streets. I made bad companions.
It's quite unfortunate. What happened then?
I was eager to taste pleasure far beyond my means. I began to bet on horses. Soon, I lost all my savings.
Quite natural. What did you do?
I made an effort to recoup. I took some money from the office safe for a final gamble. I was sure to win.
Did you win?
No. I failed again. I was terrified of the prosecution. I sank in despair. So, I shut myself in my room and turned on the gas.
How senseless.
Dear children, let's get back to the story. In the last episode, we could see Dr. A.J. Cronin saved the life of the young man who had made an attempt to suicide. After regaining his consciousness, he started telling his story to the doctor and others. Don't you want to know the rest of the story? Let's read paragraphs 14 to 17. A long bar of silence throbbed in the little attic when he concluded this halting confession. Then gruffly, the sergeant asked how much he had stolen. £7.10. The answer sounded pitiful. For this paltry sum, he had almost thrown away his life. There was a pause. The three of us, the surgeon, the landlady, and me, as the sole witnesses of the near tragedy, had the same unspoken thought in our minds. We decided to give the young man a fresh start. The surgeon, at considerable risk to his job, resolved to make no report upon the case, so that no court proceedings would result. The landlady offered a month's free board until he should get upon his feet again. While I, making perhaps the least contribution, came forward with £7.10 for him to put back in the office safe. The ship moved on through the still darkness of the night. There was no need of speech. With a tender gesture, Mrs. John had taken her husband's hand. And as we sat in silence, I could not but reflect that it was the best investment I had made in my life. It had paid me no dividends in worldly goods, but had turned out to be immensely profitable. It stood out against all the bad investments I had made throughout the years. Those foolish speculations for material gain, producing only anxiety, disappointment, and frustration. Dear children, who were the witnesses of the tragedy? Dr. A.J. Cronin, the sergeant of police, and the landlady. How much had he stolen? 7 pounds and 10 shillings. Have you seen pounds and shillings? See the images of pounds and shillings. Children, now you read the paragraphs once again. Mark the unfamiliar words. Guess the meaning from the context. And don't forget to refer to the glossary.
A long bar of silence throbbed in the little attic when he concluded this halting confession. Then, gruffly, the sergeant asked how much he had stolen. 7 pounds, 10 shillings. The answer sounded pitiful. For this paltry sum, he had almost thrown away his life. There was a pause. The three of us, the sergeant, the landlady, and me, as the sole witnesses of the near tragedy, had the same unspoken thought in our minds. We decided to give the young man a fresh start. The sergeant, at considerable risk to his job, resolved to make no report upon the case so that no court proceedings would result. The landlady offered a month's free board until he should get upon his feet again. While I, making perhaps the least contribution, came forward with 7 pounds, 10 shillings for him to put back in the office safe. The ship moved on through the still darkness of the night. There was no need of speech. With a tender gesture, Mrs. S. had taken her husband's hand. And as we sat in silence, I could not but reflect that it was the best investment I had made in my life. It had paid me no dividends in worldly goods, but had turned out to be immensely profitable. It stood out against all the bad investments I had made throughout the years. Those foolish speculations for material gain, producing only anxiety, disappointment, and frustration.
Okay, you have seen that the young man concluded his confession. When the young man concluded his confession, what did the sergeant of police ask him gruffly? Do you know the meaning of the word gruffly? Do you know what gruffly means? Gruffly means in a rough and unfriendly manner. What did the sergeant of police ask him in a rough manner? The sergeant of police asked him how much he had stolen from the office safe. How much had he stolen? 7 pounds and 10 shillings. A very small amount. A meager amount. Can you pick out from the paragraph the word which means very small? Excellent. Paltry. Friends, after hearing the story of the young man, what did the doctor, the sergeant of police, and the landlady decide? They decided to give him a fresh start, a new life. How did the sergeant of police help him? The sergeant of police resolved or decided not to report the case of his suicide attempt so that he could avoid court proceedings. What did the landlady offer him? The landlady offered a month's free food and stay. What was A.J. Cronin's contribution? He gave £7.10 to the young man to put back in the office safe. Now, look at the question number 15 on page number 81. The sergeant, the landlady, and the narrator helped the young man complete the table. Children, why does the doctor say that it was the best investment he ever made? Can you tell me? Right. The doctor gave the young man £7.10 to put back in the office safe in order to save him from punishment. Later, he became a solicitor. He became a lawyer and the director of a charitable organization. It was not an investment in terms of material gain, but his service to the society was the real investment, which was much, much greater than the money he invested. Okay, what, according to the narrator A.J. Cronin, does the investment for material gain produce? It produces only frustration, disappointment, and anxiety. ഭൗതികമായ നേട്ടങ്ങൾക്ക് വേണ്ടിയുള്ള നിക്ഷേപങ്ങൾ എന്നും ഉത്കണ്ഠയും നിരാശയും മോഹഭംഗവും മാത്രമേ ഉണ്ടാക്കുകയുള്ളൂ. ഫ്രണ്ട്സ്, നൗ യു ഹാവ് റെഡ് ദ ഹോൾ സ്റ്റോറി. ഡു യു തിങ്ക് ദ ടൈറ്റിൽ ദ ബെസ്റ്റ് ഇൻവെസ്റ്റ്മെൻറ്റ് ഐ എവർ മെയ്ഡ് ഈസ് അപ്രോപ്രിയേറ്റ് ടു ദ സ്റ്റോറി? ലെറ്റ്സ് ഹാവ് എ ഡിസ്കഷൻ. What does the word investment mean? The word investment means the act of putting money, time, or efforts into something to make a profit. What do we usually invest money on? We usually invest money on business or something which gives us material gain. How much was the narrator's investment here? £7.10. Did he get any material gain? No, not at all. What could he gain? He could save the life of a young man. How did it become an investment? It became an investment because it could change the life of a young man completely. Later, the young man became a solicitor, a lawyer. He became the director of a charitable organization. What did he do as the director of a charitable organization? He took boys and girls from city slums who were punished by the law. He also took derelict adolescents from the juvenile court, healed them in mind and body by placing them in a healthy atmosphere. They were also given training in some handicrafts so that they could live as good citizens in the society. What, according to A.J. Cronin, is the best investment and why? According to A.J. Cronin, the money he gave to the young man is the best investment. Not in terms of material gain, but in terms of the manifold benefits it could give to the society. The young man he helped later became a great social worker. He became the director of a charitable organization. A.J. Cronin considers this act of service as something more profitable than any other material profit he could ever make in his life. It was not he who was benefited, but many children who were delinquent and maladjusted. Children, consolidate all these points and write a paragraph about how the title of the story is appropriate and send it to your teacher. Friends, suppose the doctor writes a diary entry on the day he saved the life of Mr. John. What would be the diary entry like? You have already studied how to write a diary. Let's analyze the features of a diary. See here, this is the diary entry of Mr. John, which he wrote on the day he met Dr. A.J. Cronin the second time, after several years. What are the points you should remember when you write a diary? Tell me. Yes. There should be the date and time. See here. Sunday, 5th June. Okay. How would you begin a diary? You can use expressions like, what a memorable day, what a terrible experience, today is the happiest day in my life. What is written after that? Events. Which tense is used to explain events? Simple past tense. Tell me what tense is used to explain feelings and emotions? Simple present tense. What is the narrative technique used? The first person narrative. What do you notice about the language style? Simple and emotive language. What kind of sentences are used to express feelings? Exclamatory sentences. Friends, I'm sure you have enjoyed the story very much. Now it's time to wind up. I am Pavitran Mavila, signing off.